click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the valence bond theory as well as we have also talked about the hybridization, and now we are going to talk about molecular orbital theory. So what is molecular orbital theory and what are the postulates behind that? Let us talk about it. So friends, in the previous lecture we have told you that we have learned about the valence bond theory as well as the hybridization concept, and now we are going to talk about the molecular orbital theory. So what does this theory means and what are the postulates behind this and how it is very much helpful in understanding that how the molecules are being formed because of the two atoms or multiple atoms. So this is what we are going to talk about. So let us find out then what are the postulates behind it. So talking about the first one, that is, the electrons in a molecule are present in the various molecular orbitals as the electrons of the atoms are present in various atomic orbitals. Yes, this atomic orbital, suppose if I am talking about atomic orbital, and as we know that we can fill the electrons from lower energy to higher energy, and that's the reason that even a particular subshell will have a particular orbital. For example, S consists of only one orbital. While talking about P, it consists of three orbitals, that is PX, PY and PZ. Similarly, D also have and F also have. So while filling the electrons, electrons are being filled in the atomic orbitals. So this is the thing that we are talking about, atomic orbitals. But we have never heard of molecular orbital. So similarly, the molecular orbitals, when they are being formed because of the atomic orbitals, even they are being filled in that manner where we could see the atomic orbitals, electrons are being filled. So this is what it represents, that is, the electrons in the molecules are present in the various molecular orbitals as the electrons of the atoms are being present in various atomic orbitals. So this is what the first point was. And talking about the second point, that is the atomic orbitals, this is what I am representing at AU, that is the atomic orbitals of the comparable energies and the proper symmetry combined to form molecular orbitals. So this is the main point that we are going to talk about. So talking about energy, obviously we know that while filling the electrons, we follow the Abbas principle also, and we know that electrons are present in various orbits, and those orbits are also been divided into, that is, orbitals. So if we will say in that manner that the energy of a particular orbital will be comparatively different from that of the other orbitals, and that is what the energy level is having a particular value. So that is the reason that the orbitals which are belonging to particular energy level will have the filling of electrons in such a manner that when two atomic orbitals, when they are combining with each other so as to form a molecule, then it has been noted that the two atomic orbitals, they will have almost the same energy, and then only they will combine. For an example, if I would say, so there are a few examples that we are going to talk in future also, but for an example, if I am talking about helium, so helium which has an outermost shell of, that is 2s. So we know that this 2s orbital will combine with that of the other lithium molecule or the other lithium atoms 2s, and because of they have the similar energy, and then only they will combine with each other, and then only we could say that the symmetry would be that is sustained, and that is how the two atoms, they combine with each other so as to form a molecule. So this is what the second point is, and it is indicating about the energy as well as the proper symmetry. So there are a few examples that we are going to talk in future, and then it would be clear, very much clear, that why we are talking about this second point. So now let us talk about the third point that we have. So the third point says that an electron in an atomic orbital is influenced by the nucleus, but in molecular orbital it is influenced by two or more nuclei depending upon the number of atoms in the molecule. So this is what I want to talk about. So that is for a particular atom, suppose the atom consists of electrons as well as the nucleus. So all the electrons that are present in an atom, or that are present in various subshells or various orbits, so all these electrons are being influenced by the nucleus of a single atom, suppose if I'm talking about. But when I'm talking about molecules, so obviously a molecule is a combination of two or more atoms. So what happened is, because one of the electron of a particular atom in a molecule will have not only an influence with that of its own nucleus, but it can also have an influence by the other nucleus, and that is how we have mentioned over here that during the molecular orbitals, the electrons are being influenced by two or more nuclei depending upon how much atoms are being combined so as to form a particular molecule. So this is what even they will have an influence on it, because the two nucleus or more than two nucleus, even they will have an influence on the electrons of the different atoms what they are combining with each other. So this is also playing a very vital role, that this doesn't remains same just like that of the atomic orbital, because in when we are talking about an atomic orbital, it is only concerned with that of only one atom, and that's the reason only one nucleus will be able to have an influence with that of the all the electrons that are present in the atom, or which are present in different locations or different orbitals in an atom. But when it comes to molecule, so even different kind of nucleus or different nucleus will have an influence on each other's electrons. So that is what it was talking about. So now talking about the next one, that is the fourth one. So the fourth point says that the number of molecular orbitals formed is equal to the combining atomic orbitals. Yes. So suppose if two atomic orbitals, if they are combining with each other so as to form a particular molecule, and suppose the two atomic orbitals are of two different atoms or of two similar atoms when they are combining with each other. So suppose if one atom or one orbital combines with that of the other atoms, one orbital, and then the two molecular orbitals will be formed. So this is a very clear indication that the number of molecular orbital that forms, it will be equal to the combining atomic orbitals, and then only we could say that the number of atomic orbitals that take participation in formation of molecule will create the same amount of molecular orbitals whenever a molecular orbital has been formed. So this is what the fourth point is. And let us talk about the another one. But before talking about the another point, but let me tell you, whenever the two atomic orbitals, they will combine with each other, and according to that they will create the same number of molecular orbital. So during this process, basically what happens is the two kind of energy levels it is being created, and that is, one is known as the bonding orbital, while the other one is known as antibonding orbital. So when I'm talking about the second point that I was talking about, that is when the atomic orbitals, they combine with each other, or which have basically comparable energies, or which have symmetry. So whenever they combine with each other, they have a particular energy level, that is the atomic orbital have particular energy level. But whenever they combine with each other so as to form the same number of or the total number of atomic orbitals that take participation so as to form a molecular orbital. So in this case, the molecular orbitals that are being formed are being divided into two kind of energy levels. That is, one of the molecular orbital will be having a lower energy, while the one of the molecular orbital will have higher energy. So the one which has basically lower energy is very much influenced in having more symmetry and more stability. While talking about the one which has higher energy, it is less stable. But since the both are also a very helpful in formation of a molecular orbital, so this is what we could see in our next lecture also. But this is what I have given you a short glimpse about it. So let us talk about the next point. So the fifth point says that the bonding molecular orbital has lower energy, whereas the antibonding molecular orbital has higher energy. So it has been noted that the molecular orbital which has basically the lower energy are basically more stable, because lesser the energy, more is its stability. And talking about the antibonding molecular orbital, yes, the more the energy, the lesser will be its stability. So this is what I have talked about earlier also. And this too, that is antibonding and bonding orbitals, this plays a very vital role in formation of a molecule, because this not only gives us the idea that how much the energy level decreases or how much the energy level rises, but it gives an idea that how the molecule has become more stable when it was not being stable like when it was present in an atomic form. So that is the reason that in the future also we are going to talk about this thing, and we'll get to know that why the molecules are basically, some of the molecules are basically more stable compared to that of their atomic nature. So in the future also we are going to study about that, how a molecule is basically more stable, even though more stable than that which is present in its atomic state. So that is what we are going to talk about, and let us talk about the next one, that is the sixth point. So talking about the sixth point says that just as the electron probability distribution around a nucleus in an atom is given by the atomic orbital, so similarly the electron probability distribution around a group of nuclei in a molecule is given by the molecular orbital. So atomic orbital doesn't give only the detail about the filling of electrons, but it also gives the detail about the electron probability, or we could say like electron distribution around the nucleus, and that is what we are talking about for a particular atom. But when it comes to the molecule, and obviously a molecule is basically made up of more than two atoms, and that could be same atoms also, or that could be different atom also. But each of the nucleus of a particular atom is been surrounded, not only it is been surrounded by the electrons of its own, but it can be surrounded by the nucleus of the other atoms also, and or we could say that it could also be surrounded by the electrons of the other atoms. So this is what it says, that the electron probability distribution around the group of nuclei or the nuclei, because only we have got to know in our previous lecture also that whenever the two atoms they combine with each other, obviously the nucleus have an influence on the other nucleus also. So that is what I wanted to explain, that the electrons have, or the electron distribution that I was talking about. So when it comes to a molecule, so that is being given by the molecular orbital. So it is very similar to that what we talk about the atomic orbital. So similarly, we are talking about the molecular orbital. But the difference is, in atomic orbital, we are talking about atom. While I'm talking about the molecular orbital, we are talking about the molecules or the atoms that are being combining so as to form a molecule. So this is was the sixth point is, and the both are almost the same, but the ideology is the same. And now let us talk about the next one, that is, the seventh point. So the seventh point says that the molecular orbitals obey the following rules as do the atomic orbitals. So the atomic orbital, as if it follows the rule. So similarly, the molecular orbitals have also are following the same rule, and that is what we have observed in the sixth point of this theory, that is not only for electron distribution, but also for that what we have saw, that whenever the two atom, suppose if two atomic orbitals they are combining, so obviously two molecular orbitals will be formed. So that is what we have learned in our previous points. And let us talk about the another thing that I am going to talk about, that is the electron filling is accordance with the Ebbers principle, it obeys the Pauli's exclusive principle and Hertz rule of maximum anticipity. So similarly, when we are talking about that is filling the atomic orbitals, or like filling the electrons in the various shells, so we always consider that we should fill the electrons in various shell depending upon the energy, and that is what we are talking about the Ebbers principle. And we have got to know also that how can we represent the electronic configuration of a particular atom, and that also we are filling it with the according to that of the Ebbers principle, like that of, I would say, like first we'll fill it with 1s, then 2s, then 2p, then 3s, then 3p. Then in spite of filling it in 3D, we fill it first with 4s, then we move on to 3D. So it depends on the energy level, and that is what the Ebbers principle is. So while filling the electrons in the atomic orbital also, we consider the same thing. So but in talking about in molecular orbitals, even though in molecular orbitals we obey the same rule of the Ebbers principle, and according to that only we fill the electrons depending upon the energy level, or depending upon the Ebbers principle that we have got to know. So that is what we can learn in our future lecture. So that is the molecular orbital diagrams of various molecules. So this is also playing a very vital role in understanding this whole molecular orbital theory. And that is very much helpful in understanding that how the molecules are being formed because of the atomic orbitals. So now let us talk about the next one, that is obeying Pauli's exclusive principle. We know that two electrons of the same atom cannot have all the same quantum numbers or set of quantum numbers. So similarly, when it comes to the molecular orbital also, so even the molecular orbitals, they obey the Pauli's exclusive principle, and the two electrons of the molecule will not have the same set of quantum numbers, and that is what the Pauli's exclusive principle is. And talking about the main thing, yes, this is also the main thing that I'm going to talk about, and that is Hertz rule of maximum anticipity. Yes, by filling the electrons, that is, I'm talking about the Hertz rule. Suppose if I'm talking about the p orbital, suppose if three vacant orbitals are, suppose if three vacant orbitals are being present, that is px, py, and pz, and we have basically three electrons so as to fill. So we don't fill it the two electrons in the px first, and then we'll fill it one electron in the p1. So that is not the correct method to filling, and that is what the Hertz rule is not being obeyed. But suppose if we have three electrons and we have three empty that is p orbitals, that is px, py, and pz. And we should obey the Hertz rule, and that is we have to fulfill the electron in such a way that each of the orbital should occupy at least one electron, and then the filling will start, and or then the pairing will start. So that's the reason that the px will have one electron, the py will have one electron, and the pz will also have one electron. So that is what the Hertz rule is, what we have studied during the filling of electrons in the atomic orbitals. But when we are talking about the molecular orbital, even the molecular orbital should have to follow the same rule, that is, even though it is Ebbers principle, or even though when you are talking about the Pauli's exclusive principle, or mainly that is Hertz rule of maximum anticipity. So this is playing a vital role, and this all principles are basically are obeyed during the formation of a molecule, during the molecular orbital theory, that is what we are talking about. So this all should be obeyed and we should concern with that. So this is what I was talking about, that is the molecular orbital theory. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to clear your various concepts behind this. And I hope you have understood this video and you share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much.